Hey folks, how's it going? It's Robert here. We're out for another day here. I'm gonna go back out. I'm gonna shoot the second segment in my video for what I take in the wintertime with me out when I'm camping. I did a piece on what I wear for my clothing. I'm actually gonna do my tarp system. I will also do my sleep system in this video too, so you folks stick with me and I'll be back. Folks, that's what my pack system looks like, loaded up with all the gear. It's about, I think, around 22 pounds. I'll weigh it and let you know. But that's got my wool under blanket. It's got my 10x10 Tyvek tarp. Tyvek. I guess it's Tyvek, whatever you want to call it. It's called something else, but it's the same as Tyvek. My sleeping bag, that's good to like minus 15. And my food and all my cook gear is in there. The same stuff I carry in my bag all the time. Plus, I also have room on the side of it. I can attach, you know, if I wanted to take a sleep mat there, I can still got enough room on the straps to attach more on the top, and I can go with more on the bottom too, because actually it's still not really that high. So, and I mean, it all fits and wears well. And the only thing I don't have in there is my hatchet. I have everything else except my hatchet, but my hatchet would be easy to slide in there. You get attach it anywheres on there, right? Or my pole axe, whatever I want it to use.
It was starting to get a bit hot, so took off my pants that I was wearing. I'm gonna come over on the bike. Strap them onto the top of the bag.
Okay folks, this is where I'm gonna do the video at. So we'll get the tarp and stuff set up. You guys have all seen that before, so I'll get that set up and then I'll be back.
This is what my winter setup consists of. It's my sleeping bag. This is a minus 15 bag. I have my 10x10 Tyvek tarp. And I have, I think it's like a 4x6. We'll measure here in a bit. It's just a 4x6 tarp that has Mylar safety blanket tarp. And of course I have my under quilt. That's probably about, well, I guess it's between 30 and 36 inches, right? And it's doubled over and folded like twice, wool blanket, which is pretty warm. I mean, you can use it as a covering like this if you want it to keep you warm. You know, if you had to, if your back was cold and you're up against a fire, okay, you could use it a lot of different ways. Has shock cords tied to it, so we'll get the tarp and stuff set up and then we'll be back. And of course, my hammock's there too. You guys have all seen my hammock. So I'm gonna get the ropes and stuff ready for this and I'll get it set up and I'll show you. tighten it up a bit more. But when I get in, I lay down the tarp, it doesn't touch me anywheres. I'll show you the inside of that now.
I got no doors for it, but, and from the air, you can barely see it because of the color it is. It'll shed water like crazy. I tie a drip line here and a drip line here. That way when I'm in it, you can come in, see what it looks like. I'm in here. I got quite a bit of movement when I get in it. Right, I won't be swinging all night, but same way as up here, got a fair amount of headroom. Right, and you get in it, right in it, you're out of the way. So, again, like I said, I can tie that tie out too, out on the sides. I might do that, show you what it looks like. But let's go back to, I show you something else we can do too. So that's what it looks like. I got my Mylar blanket on there too. So I get it in on under me too. I can actually tighten it up a little bit on the edges if I want to. Right, so there's no wind blowing in. But that's basically how it works. That's on there underneath the blanket when I get in. Of course, my sleeping bag is here. I can just get in my sleeping bag and pull it in on top of me, or I can get in it and zip it right up to the top and then get in my hammock. I got a tendency to get up through the night because I drink so much coffee. So my sleeping bag has actually got a foot box on it. Here, so my feet actually go in and are completely encased, and then I can unzip it all the way to the top and just tuck it in around me, and that way if I get cold through the night, a different spot, I can move my sleeping bag around and I can bunch up the top. The top's got drawstrings on it. You can put like your jacket and stuff in there and bunch it all up, and it makes like a pillow. I also use the bag too. I put my jacket or whatever's in there through the night that I have used as a pillow. Where I can, you know, bunch it up beside me and sleep on it. If I'm cold in a spot, I can, you know, pull my stuff at it, my extra gloves or whatever I'm carrying. Well, if I have an extra sweater or something with me, I can pull it right out of the bag and use it during the night, and that way it's right in there with me. So that's the basic setup there. It's pretty comfortable. I like it a lot. You know, and it's not like if I need to, if I get cold, I can take another wool blanket with me. I can strap two more wool blankets right on the side and
throw them on in on top of me. And I mean, I'll never be cold. I'm gonna eventually get some shock cord to use for with my tarp. The sheet of I was gonna go with that ripstop nylon that you buy, but Tyvek, I mean it's cheap. It was $20, $19.99 plus taxes for the sheet. So you couldn't ask for anything cheaper. And I mean it's 9x10 or something like that, so it's good and big. And again, if I wanted to, I could, like if I got a lot of wind, I can tie this out to a tree off to one side with a piece of paracord. But I got marbles in the ends of my tarp to hold them together. Hey, you could use anything you want. I had marbles, that's what I used. And I mean, I've used this tarp quite a few times. It's pretty good for not ripping. My prussic knots are what hold my my tarp tight. I mean, I just tie my gear off when I tie it. It's usually tied in the first little cross knot that you use, and then it's tied in a fashion like that so that it doesn't come loose, right? So I usually go around, right? Wrap it around so it stays there. And then you tie it off in that first knot, right? Same as this way, right? And then I just do this with it up through and pull it down on itself tight, and you got a knot that is really taut when you come to undo it. It's just that simple like that, and it comes right undone, right? And that's what the knot I use on pretty much all my stuff when I tie it off, right? You can take your corners too and close them off on the ends. You just crisscross the lines. This one you can pull in tighter. It works pretty good. I mean, if you got heavy rain, you can close it off pretty much to the point where there ain't nothing going to get in at you or to you. You can bunch them here too, tie them up with a piece of string, right? If you got heavy torrential rains, bunch it up here on the ends. Pull out your sides here, right? Hang it to something over there. Same as what I did on that one. Same as this end, you can bunch it off. Right, once it's pulled out, you'd never know that you weren't that you were in a hammock for sure. Right, there's all kinds of room on this side in there. So well, that's what you got. You can bunch it right off, so it works pretty good to keep the wind and stuff out. It'd have been nice if the tarp had been. I think the next time I do it. Well, that hammock is long too, eh? It's long. It's like, it's probably 2 feet longer than what I really need to be. I mean, one of them shorter hammocks that are 6 feet, 6.5, you'd have no problem sleeping in. It's a little harder to get into, but you're as snug as a bug in a rug. Again, if you got heavy rain, you take the corners, bunch them together, tie a piece of rope on it, right? There's not too much going to get in there, right? There you are. Oh, going the wrong way. Forgot the camera was over here. If you want, you can bunch it together too, eh? The ends, right? Put them all together and tie with a little piece of string, and pretty much any drip that starts will stop right there. So that's how you do it. When you get in, you just gotta get in from under here or over there, whatever, right? Works pretty good, stops mostly all the wind. Works good in the winter. You close it all in with snow at the bottom, and it's just pretty toasty warm in there. Right, it's like a cocoon, right? So there it is, a Tyvek tarp. Yep. Hope you enjoyed this little segment on my winter sleep system. Anyway, folks, I'm going to finish my coffee. You guys have a great day, and we'll see you later.